Welcome to Tell Me the Treasures. Today we're learning Sota page 10, which discusses a very fascinating concept that it's brought down that there are five different places in our Jewish history where people were given an enormous great level of blessing, some great quality that made them so unique and special above and beyond anyone else. And yet, it was that very same thing that caused their downfall. And first, after I share with you these five, I'd like to discuss why that is what happens. And on this, the Talmud gives, for example, Shimshon. We learned about Samson, who we know who had this long, beautiful hair. He was also extremely strong. He was known to be a great warrior, and he was very successful in fighting in many different ways against the Philistines. However, it turned out that it was his very strength that was taken away from him, and therefore he was able to be captured. We find this when it came to the very first king of Israel, who was Saul or Shaul, that he was labeled and described as physically heads and shoulders above everyone else. He was very, very tall. And yet, even though he was so tall, it says when he was about to be killed, instead he fell on the sword, which is at the very end of Samuel 1. A third incident is of Absalom, who was the son of King David, who rebelled against his father. Now, he had beautiful hair. And even though he was so beautiful with his hair, when he was riding, as it's discussed, he was on an animal, and there was an elm tree, and his hair got stuck on the branches, and the animal just continued riding, and he was there dangling with his hair being stuck there, and that's ultimately how he died, because of his hair. Sidkiah, he was someone who was blessed with great vision. He was able to see quite well, but yet he was blinded. And then finally, a person by the name of Asa, who had great ability to run, one of the fastest runners imaginable, and yet at the very end of his life, he developed an illness called gout, which actually was considered to be a punishment to him because he mistreated scholars and also a bride and groom who just started their life. He immediately made them work and never gave them a break. Now, even though each of these stories are a little bit different, but nonetheless, there is this common thread that goes through all five of them. And that is, a person could have a great, great positive quality, but that could be very much their downfall. Now, what does that mean? And does that apply to this day and age? So there are a lot of people, for example, who are extremely, extremely smart. And because of that, they go through their elementary years, high school, and maybe even undergrad, and they just coast through because they're so smart. And they therefore, based on their knowledge, just rely on that, even though they didn't really develop a work ethic. And then all of a sudden, when they end up going to, let's say, medical school, and where they're surrounded by all smart people, they're not able to succeed because they relied so much on this one blessing without truly developing it. Therefore, it ends up becoming their very downfall. And it's the same thing when it comes to beauty, which is what we see here. And we see so many times, if all you have is your physical beauty, your beauty will fade. Unfortunately, that is just a reality of life. And therefore, if your beauty is something which is so important to you, eventually you're going to lose it. And therefore, what it's come to tell you is that when you have certain God gifts that you didn't work for, you need to also cultivate other strengths in order that you become a more diverse and well-rounded person. Because just like Shaul, who was physically very tall, sometimes the bigger you are, the harder and lower you fall.